We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Because that goal will serve to organize and measure the best of our energies and skills. Because that challenge is one that we're willing to accept, one we are unwilling to postpone, and one we intend to win, and the others too.
In the beginning, people have been exploring the plains of planet Earth, from the Lewis and Clark expedition to Christopher Columbus's journey to the New World. It was evident that it was an instinct for man to explore the world. Over time, men and women are not only exploring Earth, but space and the beyond, with the help of NASA, or the National Aeronautics and Space Administration. In the course of space explorations, NASA has developed countless innovations along the way that transformed American history. The National Aeronautics and Space Administration is the most innovative government organization and made contributions to technology and science that benefited everyday human lives by doing space explorations, inventions, and paving the space age culture.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
It was September 2nd, 1945, when World War II officially came to an end. America was finally getting back on its feet. The 1950s in America was a time of new beginnings and advances.
Just let me hear some of that rock and roll music.
Music flourished with the rise of rock and roll with artists like Elvis Presley, Buddy Holly, and Chuck Berry. Economy was thriving, making America the richest nation at the time. Inventions like the television, the calculator, the washing machine, the computer, and also the new fast food chain helped the economy tremendously. Just like any other time period, there were also struggles in America in the 1950s. This era was a major setback for women. About 2 million women lost their jobs from the time of World War II once their husbands came back from war.
We shall overcome!
Meanwhile, African Americans were getting closer and closer for equality, with events like the bus boycott, the Little Rock, and abolishing segregation at schools. There was relief and happiness as World War II ended. However, the same terrified feelings came back shortly. America was in fear of the Soviet Union and other nations spreading their communism. Instantly, America and other democratic nations found itself in another war with the communist nations and the Soviet Union as their leader. It was a heated competition of nuclear weapons, economy, education, and world power. It was soon called the Cold War. During the Cold War, many events occurred. For example, the Soviet Union set off their own atomic bomb, Joe McCarthy begins his communist hunt, South and North Korea was at war called the Korean War, Vietnam divided into the 17th parallel, while the Eastern nations signed the Warsaw Pact in 1955. All of these events led up to the most important driving force for the creation of NASA. On October 1957, the Soviet Union launched the first man-made satellite. It was called Sputnik.
Today, a new moon is in the sky, a 23-inch metal sphere placed in orbit by a Russian rocket. Hear an artist's conception of how the feat was accomplished. A three-stage rocket. Number one, the booster in the class of an intercontinental missile. Its weight estimated at 50 tons. The smaller second stage took over at 5,000 miles an hour and carried on to the highest point reached. 500 miles up, the artificial moon is boosted to a speed counterbalancing the pull of gravity and released. You are hearing the actual signals transmitted by the Earth-circling satellite. One of the great scientific feats of the age.
Sputnik was a huge hot topic around the world. An American named Pam Miller recalled, "It was like bread. Everyone knew it." There was a great panic across the nation. America was behind the space race. Senator Lyndon B. Johnson warned America, "Soon, the Russians will be dropping bombs on us from space like kids dropping rocks into cars from freeway overpasses." Also, former astronaut Richard Mullane remembered the night Sputnik was launched. It was like Halloween. A tiny light appeared on the southwestern horizon and slowly glided over our heads. People stood in awe. Some cried. Some were frightened. While most was in panic, the 34th President of the United States of America, Dwight D. Eisenhower, remained calm. He did not care one iota that the Soviets have put one small ball in the air. He reminded America that they have future plans of launching their own satellite in 1958. No one knew that the scientific satellite program would turn out to be a race. America had the necessary rocket technology. However, the reason why America was lagging behind the space race is that they appointed the wrong people to do the job. During 1957, the Naval Research Laboratory, a military organization, was assigned to the program. The program was strictly a scientific endeavor, not a military one. In a result, the U.S. Naval team made early launches because of the intense pressure made by the Soviets. The outcome became a flopnik, or kaputnik, as people joked. Even though there was success with the first American satellite, Explorer 1, which was assigned to the Redstone Arsenal, a military team, there was debate if space programs should be assigned to military agencies or civilian agencies. Paul G. Demling, the former legal representative for NASA, announced that the Air Force felt that it should be the agency to do all the space research, but the Atomic Energy Commission felt very strongly that if we're going to go into space, nuclear power was going to put us there, and therefore it should be the agency to assume that role. The team of Explorer 1 was a good candidate, but it was when Dr. James Killian persuaded President Eisenhower to make the new space agency a civilian one, not military. Dr. James Killian was the first presidential assistant for science and technology. He was known for being the architect of the creation of NASA. His job at the time, as President Eisenhower said, helping me follow through on the program of scientific improvement of defenses. He defined this new agency as civilian-directed and civilian-oriented space science and exploration program. Therefore, on October 1, 1958, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration was created under the National Aeronautics and Space Act. NASA's mission is to pioneer the future in space exploration, scientific discovery, and aeronautics research. Their work ranges from the everyday operating in their facilities to explore the mind-boggling, furthest limits of the past, present, and future of our universe. NASA's activities are devoted to peaceful purposes for the benefit of all mankind, under the Space Act. NASA provides almost everyone in the world benefits in their lives. Such examples are clean water, thermometers, makeup, lightning protection, smoke detectors, rescue tools, golf ball aerodynamics, laser heart surgery, and also global communication. In fact, there are over 1,650 spin-offs NASA has claimed. NASA has also been supporting environmental movements like oil spill control, caring for the oceans, and also fighting forest fires. When people of America found out about the creation of NASA, more fuel went into the excitement of the space age. There was no doubt or hesitation to accepting the new agency. Everyone was just relieved that America was finally trying to catch up with the Soviets. Americans were hungry for information about astronauts such as Mercury 7. Boys and girls across the nation all of a sudden wanted to become astronauts. With monumental explorations like Apollo 11, education has changed drastically before the space age because the world of science was given to the more modern age. Professors and authors have been using NASA's experiments and knowledge for writing textbooks. More science materials have been introduced to schools all over America. In pop culture, NASA and the space age influenced shows like Star Trek and the Jetsons. Seattle's Space Needle was built primarily for the commemoration of the space age, and furniture was influenced with space madness too. And contrary to the 50s and 60s, Americans have more job opportunities. Now, men and women with any ethnic background can achieve their dream job with less discrimination. New boundaries were broken, gender-wise, racial-wise, and age-wise. On August 30th, 1983, NASA's Space Shuttle Challenger lifted off with the first African-American, Guy Bluford, to go into space. Just this year, on April 5th, 2010, a new space record was announced that four women are in orbit at the same time, the most in space history. Before NASA, no one really knew what was life like outer space. Now with more experiments and research done, NASA has shared more knowledge of the world and the universe than any other organization. NASA has been working on colonizing outer space by learning the geology of planets, the atmosphere, and searching for human resources, an important endeavor for the future. If NASA was never made, we wouldn't have the science education and technology we have today. The organization still continues to seek for answers of the world of science, with peace for the benefit of mankind, just like 51 years ago. As of today, NASA has made 131 space shuttle launches. NASA's accomplishments has broadened throughout the years as we go deeper into space. The research NASA has made inspires many other innovations that shape the way we live. It's an innovation that creates innovations. But most importantly, NASA represents our country on Earth and in space.
Out there, there's a world outside of Yonkers, way out there beyond this hick town, Barnaby. There's a slick town, Barnaby. Out there, full of shine and full of sparkle, close your eyes and see it glisten, Barnaby. Listen, Barnaby. Put on your Sunday clothes, there's lots of world out there. Get out the brilliantine and dime cigars. We're gonna find adventure.